Trump's key advisors. Back with me now, Peter Beiner, Liz Berney, Matt Lewis, and Richard Cohen. Liz, I want to start with you because I interviewed Joel Pollack, who's Breitbart's editor-at-large last night, and he defended Steve Bannon's appointment, and he pointed to the support of your pro-Israel organization as proof that Bannon isn't anti-Semitic. What are people getting wrong about Steve Bannon?
Well, I think so many people who actually know Steve Bannon, including people that we know, have said that he is a very decent person, and from what he actually helped in our difficulties with CUNY, with the anti-Semitic protests at CUNY. He was the Breitbart people were instructed by him to contact Governor Cuomo to see that New York State would do something about this. We've also analyzed the articles that he has on Breitbart, and so many of them have been pro-Israel. Just this week, he wrote an article talking about the pain of a Jewish student who found a swastika on her doorway. This is not something that an anti-Semite would write about. He's talked about problems with the Iran deal, where many people were criticizing Netanyahu. He made sure to have a broadcast of Netanyahu's full webcast about the problems with the Iran deal. Also this week, he had another article on Breitbart about the recent violations of the Iran deal. He's somebody who has been really fighting for the pro-Israel.
So none of the other things bother you because he's so pro-Israel?
We're also talking about anti-Semitism here. And I think that a lot of the other things, it's very painful to see somebody smeared who doesn't deserve it and who's a fine human being. Okay. We've read through his article about the alt-right, and it's a piece of reporting. It's not an endorsement of the alt-right.
Okay, who is that? Is that Richard?
Yeah, I got to jump in. Look, the ADL, the leading organization fighting anti-Semitism, has condemned Mr. Bannon's appointment. Mr. Bannon has said that Breitbart is the platform for the alt-right. It's something, he's proud of it. The alt-right is basically rebranding white supremacy for the digital age. I don't know what Mr. Bannon does in his personal life. Maybe he seems like a good guy to his friends. All I know is what he's done in his public life, and that is to spread white nationalism and white supremacy.
Right, and I think it's important to recognize that a major target of Breitbart has been Muslims, right? To headlines like man bites dog, Muslim nice to non-Muslim, right? Talking about how Muslims devastate communities, about how they're taking time bomb, right? And so it's not surprising that the Zionist Organization for America, which is itself a bigoted organization against Muslims, which condemned President Obama in February when he called Islam a religion of peace. The ZOA, which has had Pamela Geller, who's called Muslim savages, who've had her speak, who've had Frank Gaffney, who called Barack Obama the first Muslim president. It's not surprising that the ZOA, which is also Islamophobic, would endorse Steve Bannon's Islamophobia.
The Southern Poverty Law Center, the Anti-Defamation League, the Religious Action Center of Reform Judaism, the Council of American Islamic Relations all oppose Bannon. Those are organizations there. These are some of the headlines that Peter mentioned here. Breitbart headlines, hoisted high and proud, the Confederate flag proclaims a glorious heritage, or an establishment conservative guide to the alt-right, or read the scary descriptions of refugees by Idaho Refugee Agency. The site also has a section of articles under the tag Black Crime. How can you separate the man from the website, Liz?
Okay, well, first of all, as I mentioned, the alt-right article is not particularly complimentary. It speaks about racism. It talks about neo-Nazis in the organization, and certainly not in complimentary terms. The people who actually work for Breitbart have been very critical of the alt-right movement. I will give you the example of there is. A series of newspapers out on Long Island, where I live. The guy who runs it is very liberal. His editorials are liberal. However, he prints everything from everybody, and this is a business decision that somebody can make. That they want to have controversy sells. If people to choose to people read this newspaper because they do have all opinions there.
Right. Okay, but people will say there's a difference between controversy and promoting, Matt, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, and coming out and saying that you are the platform for the alt-right. Do they just report on it, or do you think they promote it?
Well, I do think there's a danger that they've mainstreamed it, and that there's a, you know, it's a fine line. The piece that you're referring to, I think, it was an explainer to conservatives,
yes,
about what the alt-right is. But I also think that it misrepresented it a little bit, tried to make it sound like it's what cool young conservatives are doing, not just what, white nationalists are doing. But look, you know, Steve Bannon runs this site. To some degree, he bears responsibility for everything in it, but he didn't write that piece. And I'm willing to bet you could find titles from places I've worked and others probably on this panel that they may not agree with 100%. Mm-hmm. I think presidents have a right within reason to sort of pick the people they want advising them. And I would also say, I think that we get up in arms every 4 or 8 years over things like this. I remember it wasn't that long ago, our friend Van Jones, who was the green jobs czar or something in the Obama administration, had in his past been more of a liberal activist, had been, some people at his organization were truthers. And Glenn Beck, who was on our air not that long ago, went on a jihad against Van Jones. I think he did 14 episodes attacking him, run him out of the Obama administration. Van Jones happens to be one of the most, I think, thoughtful liberal commentators and best, you know, sort of analysts that I know. But I think that's what we do. This, I think we're overblowing this.